You have anything to say to the camera this morning?
I'm going to Disney World!
Okay. She's going to Disney World. GoPro. Behind the scenes.
Whoa!
What's going on?
Yay!
Yeah!
World.
Wedding
We're
time!
Going to Disney!
Yay!
Are
y'all?
We met started like, I'm going to Disney World!
Okay, we're good for right now.
Okay.
You need to work on your hair
just a little bit.
Okay. Because you can see the little clip. Hold on.
Okay,
there you go.
Okay.
Without the same.
We good?
I'm out yet.
Okay.
Never mind, I'll just wait.
Are you ready for the chicken dinner?
Yeah.
That's like one thing I put on the list that they can't play out.
So we'll just make it up as it goes.
You're still
on. I like how we're still playing though.
Hey, let's take
There's only 3 hours of footage allowed.
Team Marie, get in here.
Go down.
Hold on, let's put it down. Wait, do you look at the camera?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
You didn't get up.
Okay, Dean Marie, you gotta go down lower. Okay. Wait, now look at the camera.
Oh, the flash.
The flash.
How do you turn it off?
Close it.
Okay, one more.
Whatever.
You hit them.
Alright, you're on.
Wait. Hold on. One more.
Close that door.
Mom, close the door.
Wait.
Mom, close it. Close it.
Close it.
Close it.
Right, Philip.
I can ignore the right door.
No, you can't.
Dang it.
Just hold it down.
Nope, here.
Right here.
Whatever.
You want to say anything to Maggie before she gets married?
This is just a few minutes before you become Mrs. Knudsen.
So,
smile, pretty girl, syrup, and Debbie loves ya.
You guys all got to say, give a message to Maggie. Pre-wedding, you got 10 minutes until this thing happens.
Congrats,
what do you got to say?
Maggie.
Congrats. Here we go.
I love you, sweetie. T-minus 10 minutes, Maggie.
Saw the picture and you look great, Maggie.
Congratulations, I'm happy for you.
Pastor Bob, your turn.
Bless your heart. You can do this. You can do it.
There we go. Well, I love you, Maggie. Good luck.
Make it your mom.
Oh, sexy.
Woo!
Oh, look
at you. Yeah.
Don't you dare.
For the new pocket.
Ow, ow.
That's mine for the new pocket.
Baby.
Camera. You're on camera right now.
Tell me about
it.
That's
scary.
Good.
Hey, okay.
What is going on?
2 hour noises. Good.
Yeah, put a camera in front of me. That's all I need is a camera. Where's the camera?
Hey, Mom. Imagine everyone naked.
Well, that's what the photo booth guy just said. Just imagine everybody naked. I'm like, okay, really?
Not me.
No, don't worry.
The boys were about to change shirts and they're like,
shut up. Woo, baby.
This is getting weird.
Is
it still filming? Okay. Yeah. Filming the whole time.
Right on.
Good. Make weird faces.
Yeah, that is so funny.
Right on. Yeah.
baby.
I'm sitting next to
What arm is this on?
I got, I don't know.
Put it on the other arm.
The left.
I love those flowers.
Those are beautiful.
I love them.
She looks like she's crying and just
don't waste the battery on my tears.
You're crying. I'm just sweating. I'm glistening.
No, 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 yeah, not yet. I'm coming back. Yep. You wait. I'm dropping Amy.
Yeah.
for generations. Wives have been watching their sailors deploy to other lands and countries, awaiting their return. Each reunion, a celebration of life and marriage, the start of another honeymoon. Each day and week and month together, so precious and so intense. Each day away, the heart indeed grows much fonder for both the sailor and his bride. This is the sacrifice, not only of military men and women, but also of their families. A wife must be strong, emotionally, physically, and to hold down the fort while the husband, her sailor, is away. She will be asked to do all things, even mundane things like take out the trash. It'll all be on her. The man, too, must be strong emotionally and physically as he awaits their reunion. Absence does make the heart grow fonder, and your love for each other will grow in depth as you experience military life together. Marcus, do you take Maggie to be your lawfully wedded wife, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love her, honor her, comfort her, and cherish her from this day forward, keeping yourself only for her for as long as you both shall live? Do you?
I do.
And Maggie, do you take Marcus to be your lawfully wedded husband, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love, honor, comfort, and cherish him from this day forward, and keeping yourself only for him for as long as you both shall live? Do you?
I do.
The Bible has much to say about love. It has defined love in our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. And Paul has this to say to the church in Corinth regarding love. 1 Corinthians 13, verses 4 through 8, where the Apostle Paul writes, "Love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. Love is not rude. Love is not self-seeking, nor is it easily angered. Love keeps no record of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. Love always protects, always trusts, always hopes. Love always perseveres. Love never fails." Amen. Marcus and Maggie are offering rings as constant reminders of their love for each other. The wedding ring is the most universal symbol of not only love, but also commitment known around the world. The ring is a circle which has no end. It visualizes the love that you two are promising to each other today. And may these rings always remind you and others here today of this moment when your lives were joined together and your hearts were joined as one. Marcus, as you slip that on her finger, you repeat after me. I, Marcus, take you, Maggie, to be my wedded wife.
I, Marcus, take you, Maggie, to be my wedded wife.
I promise to be your loving and faithful husband.
I promise to be your faithful and loving husband.
Your friend and your provider and your protector.
Your friend, your provider, and your protector.
For better or worse, for richer or poorer.
For better or worse, for richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health, till death do us part.
Sickness and long, till death do us part.
Good enough.
Yeah, that'll work. I might just change that. Very nice, very nice. With this ring, I pledge my life and my love to you.
With this ring, I pledge this life and this
life. I'm just changing it as I go here. It's so much better.
More personal.
And with this ring, I thee wed.
And with this ring, I thee wed.
Very nice. And Maggie, you can say anything you want.
After you put, I'll just make some suggestions.
What I would suggest that you'd say is, I, Maggie, take you, Marcus, to be my wedded husband.
I, Maggie, take you, Marcus, to be my wedded husband.
I promise to be your loving and faithful wife.
I promise to be your loving and faithful wife.
Your friend, your lover, and your encourager.
Your friend, your lover, and your encourager.
For better or worse, for richer or poorer.
For better, for worse, or richer, or poorer.
In sickness and in health, till death do us part.
In sickness and health, till death do us part.
And with this ring, I pledge this life and this love to you.
With this ring, I pledge this life and this love to you.
It's his idea.
Good idea.
And with this ring, I be wed.
With this ring, I be wed.
Yes. Now they've chosen to demonstrate visually their love and their commitment as these individual grains of sand can no longer be separated. May their bond as well be inseparable. First they're going to pour their layers of sand kind of one at a time and back and forth. Represents their individuality. Marcus is not going to become Maggie, nor Maggie become Marcus, but what they bring is very individual. And then they're going to simultaneously pour their sand together as the two colors become blended, as two lives become one life, as two individuals become a couple, and a new family is begun. Marcus and Maggie, be merciful to each other, be kind and loving to each other, be forgiving to each other. Accept life as a gift from God, and your marriage as an opportunity for the fulfillment of your lives and all that He has for you. Be patient with one another, forgive freely, and above everything else, love one another. Be truly loving, loving without manipulation, just loving because you're committed to love. Keep a short list of wrongs and a long list of sweet memories. Now that you have declared your love and commitment to one another before these friends and family, then allow me to, by the authority vested in me by the state of Florida and the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ, to pronounce you husband and wife. Marcus, you may kiss your bride. Friends and family, it gives me great pleasure and a real privilege to introduce to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Marcus Knudsen.
Maggie. Do I need to do anything to make them hurry up?
Your heart's been sweet, heart come to life. trust we bring. 100 years goes faster than we don't.
I got you. All right. Crazy. Okay. No, that's good. Come on.
A little softer. We talked earlier. I know what type of guy you are. I know. We've got something for you. Here we go.
Sure, we're
going to have Austin. That didn't work, Maggie? You can dance, too. Oh, I know dancing. I'm a DJ. We got this. All right. Oh, you guys are going to love this one. I promise. This is a good one. That's not dancing.
Come on.
Okay. Yeah, but you're my man. You're my man.
See. How about this one?
Like this, the more she screamed.
Yep.
I have no idea. Matthew painted it to me. He says, how about you do this for a while?
What am I?
Really? Carly said she wanted to get one too. But this belongs to Matthew's friend. And so they decided that this was fun. So I think we can give it up.
hitting the wall.
He just said that it's got like a fish eye or something, so you got no.
So. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's hit it for Jesse and Dakota one more time. And just for the fellas, Marcus and Maggie. We're watching you. All right, so now it is time for Mr. and Mrs. Knudsen to come to okay?
Say goodbye.
Bye.
We have nothing to do with that.